Welcome to Willie's Web, where everyone has a story. And I'm your host today, Willie Wideman-Pleasant. Boy, I tell you, it was tough today. I have poets in the house, and they're going to do some reading, and they're going to talk about their journey in poetry, and they're just going to fill your life with all this emotions and feelings and visions and dreams. So I have, let me introduce to you, she is the professor. She has taught chemistry, physics, engineering, math in colleges like MIT, Boston University. She has performed in touring companies as a choreographer, a dancer, and singing. She has sung with leading gospel, jazz groups, R&B artists, including Freda Payne, Spyro Gyro, Ron White, and her spoken word art was featured in Magic Johnson's Coffee House. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
No problem. Glad to be here.
I have next to her is my friend. He is a summa cum laude, and I'm probably not saying that right, Phi Beta Kappa graduate of Fisk University and was a graduate fellow in mass communication at Boston University. He is an accomplished trainer, a professional writer, a poet, actor, working artist. He has published books called a book called Brown Skin and the Bread of Life, A Poet's Journey. He is very involved with the art ministry at Jubilee Christian Church. Next to him is, and I probably won't say her name properly, she's a Boston native with a graduate degree from Simmons College. She identifies herself as a womanist writer. Her latest collection of poetry is called What Good is a View of Charles? She has also published a memoir and novella, which you'll talk about in the show. Her name is Megan Ariel King, and I probably didn't say that right. Thank you for coming to my show. Thank you. And last but not least, and she didn't give me a bio on her, so I don't really have a lot to say.
Okay.
But I met Yvonne at a poetry workshop at Jubilee, and she's very prolific. She's a Boston resident, Northeastern graduate, a writer, an editor, and maybe I can get her to edit my book. By professional, she's a poet, Yvonne Reddy. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
So I have viewers in my audience, and I always want to have them leave with a bit of knowledge about, and because it's Poetry Month, and I wanted to share your work with them, but I also want you to share some information about yourself, because kids always often think that they don't have time to do this. And my question to all of you, and I'll ask each person relates to the other, just you can answer it in any order you like. I would like to know is, did you, what came first, your development of your talent or the work and your career? And did you look back and decide to go backwards? So what came first for you, Maru?
Okay, I've always been an avid reader. Mm-hmm. And I think if you're an avid reader, you often turn into an avid writer. And I believe my reflections just came out in poetry. And I'm very interested in the arts. I performed and been an actor and been in dramatic, you know, performances. So the poetry just came naturally out of my interest in literature.
Mm-hmm. What about you, Terry?
I agree very much with what Maru was saying. I think that if you read a lot, then at some point in time, if you fancy yourself a writer, you'll gravitate to one genre or another, and poetry was just it for me. Very briefly, I was at Fisk University doing my undergrad, and there was a literary society that I wanted to belong to. I'm not going to say why I wanted to belong to, because it'll get me in trouble with my wife. But in any case, you had to write a collection of your work, whether it was poetry, short stories, essays, whatever. And I put together a small, you know, book, quote unquote, of poems, and that was really where my journey really jumped off from, and I've been writing ever since.
And what age were you when you started?
I think I was writing since I was maybe 14 or 15, but seriously 17 and 18 when I was a freshman in college.
Mm. Okay.
I grew up in a house full of books, and I also had a father who would sit down and read Harlem Renaissance poets, and I didn't realize until I was in college, not everybody's father just like sat around reading poetry. So it was just, you know, just sort of my natural environment.
Beautiful.
And his parents were both English teachers, so it was normal. So, and my mother was an opera major in school, so there was like words, music, just floating around the house all of the time. And I was a, you know, grew up to be a third generation teacher, but somewhere along the line, I was just like naturally, you know, a writer in, you know, have to agree. Reading, writing, they go together.
Yeah.
So if there are, you know, books, there are words everywhere, then you pick up on them if you're a writer. You don't just suddenly wake up one day and become a great writer and never having read a darn thing other than, you know, no offense, I love comic books, but, you know, so something other than comic books, you know.
Just. What about you, Yvonne?
Well, I started being interested in poetry at a young age. My earliest poems were probably about my pets, but interest in the arts, I probably would attribute to my mother taking me to poems and having music lessons, and I enjoyed reading. Once I discovered the words and the rhythm of the words, I was drawn into them, and that kind of brought me around to poetry. And overall, I'd say that it kind of took a back seat for a while as I went into the work world, and I kind of lost track of it, and then I came back around to it through probably most seriously when I hooked up with Terry through lyric.
Very good. So let's hear, and Maru, let's hear a poetry. Hey, you know what?
Hey, let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right.
I want to hear it.
All right. I should take this.
Maru.
Right.
Tell them your name so my people will know who you are, because I tear up names.
No,
I'm
no
sorry.
Problem. Maru Colbert.
Okay, you want to take the...
Okay.
Take yes, the ma'am.
All right. Okay, these, I brought a collection of poems. I'll start with the one that may be...
Just do one.
Yeah, no, sorry, I'll start with the one.
Okay.
Start and sit down.
Okay.
The one that'll work. And this is the most recent. This is an interesting one because it was inspired by the recent Martin Luther King Day.
Okay.
And because, as you know, around that holiday, not too long before Nelson Mandela had passed, and I have a friend who was a very, very prominent social justice speaker who always talked about Malcolm X. So kind of a play on the whole events, I did Martin, Malcolm, and Mandela.
Oh.
I put them together. So this has those three, just to give you a backdrop. It's entitled No Fingerprints. In the South African play, Mize Julie, the slave woman had scrubbed until she had no fingerprints. On the Law and Order episode, in order to avoid detection, the suspect had removed fingerprints. A favorite lab, DNA, forensics, biology, genetics, it's fingerprints. Removing fingerprints, the science of hurt, obliteration, pain. Martin left his imprint through Birmingham letters, an oratory at the march, his death before he reached the mountaintop. Of the freedom he fought for, fight by any means necessary, said Malcolm. Through his lenses, he saw not the American dream, but an American nightmare. He needed to push, ball his fist, his fingerprints into a fist, leave his imprint in your face before someone took him from us in the audience.